Well, a very warm welcome to today's video and to Helsinki, capital of Finland, where we start today's journey. You find me at the modern Helsinki West Harbour Terminal 2 port from where Baltic Sea operator Tallink operates a regular service to Tallinn in Estonia. With a departure time of 10:30, following a very efficient turnaround of the arriving ship, boarding commences bang on time at 9:55. Today's ship is the pride of Tallink and the Baltic Sea, known as Megastar. She's not a megastar like Steven Seagal, Michael Knight, or indeed Jason Statham, and she was named after a public consultation involving more than 20,000 people. Somehow, though, I can't help but feel that there was a bit of a missed opportunity here. In today's video, you'll see the world's first ever floating Burger King, and a very posh upgrade. So let's get on board. Tallink offers frequent and fairly priced crossings of all the main points across the Baltic, including mini cruises between Helsinki and Stockholm. The mini cruise on sister ship Silja Symphony involves 2 nights at sea with 7 hours in Stockholm. It's not really enough to see this remarkable city, but it is a mini cruise where the focus is on the ship. Prices for the mini cruise start at €119, and from there you can choose from plenty of cabin grades right up to executive suite, adding about €2,000 to the trip. Today's journey, though, on the Megastar, will see us on the simple tour crossing to Tallinn in Estonia. My first port of call is to find my seat and drop my bags off in the business lounge, where I paid an additional supplement of €69. Having secured the front seat, I can tell you that the business class lounge is extremely well fitted out and definitely has an opulent feel to it. As we head out of port, bang on time, I decide to go explore. One of the places I find is the comfort lounge. In addition to standard seating and cabins, which you can buy on this daytime sailing, Megastar also offers 2 lounge upgrade options. The first is the comfort lounge. For an additional €29, it offers basic catering and soft and hot drinks. It's nice enough. Or, if you prefer, you can pay €69, which is what I did, and opt for the business lounge. The food offering is immense, even at breakfast time, and the business lounge offers complimentary, unlimited alcohol. In addition, there are those great views right at the front of the ship. Megastar also offers complimentary Wi-Fi, which even in the middle of the Baltic Sea, offered really good speeds, and I was able to reply to some emails, catch up on Instagram, and edit some video. Let's take a further look around this 2016-born, 50,000 gross tonnage ship. One of the first things that hits you about this ship is the sheer amount of shopping available on board. The main shop literally stretches from the front of the ship all the way to the back, and prices are very reasonable in what can be a very expensive part of the world to live. You're also equally spoiled for choice when it comes to eating, with no fewer than 7 places to eat on board, including the world's first floating Burger King. You have the fast lane for basic food, moving to the Delight Buffet and the Chef's Kitchen. Prices are reasonable here too, given the captive audience and the generally high price of living in the Nordic region. If you prefer to eat in a less formal pub environment, then head over to the Sea Pub or Victory Bar. You'll be welcomed by a horse in the Victory Bar, and with plentiful seating and really nice surroundings, this is a nice place to while away the hours. They even have a beer garden, but today it was closed, as at the time of this sailing, the world was just emerging from the last 2 years. back at the nose of the ship, or is that fore or aft? Anyone know nautical terms? I'm really enjoying this relaxing alternative to flying with Finnair, who fly between Helsinki and Tallinn up to 10 times a day. Honestly, I am much preferring taking the ferry. Even in the business class lounge, it's self-service, but with few passengers on today's crossing, and even less here in the lounge, it's really no great shakes. Breakfast choice is impressive, better in fact than the hotels where I usually stay, and of course, there's free alcohol. But even for me, it's too early in the day for a Campari and soda. I opt instead for porridge, coffee, and fresh orange. When you're vlogging, it's important to stay healthy, and certainly stay out of Burger King. Three people behind me, and all three enjoying that super fast, complimentary Wi-Fi. One guy is even hosting a Zoom call, which you could also join with me if you become a Patreon supporter. It's thanks to people like Joe, James, and Kieran who help me bring you these videos every month. There's a link below if you'd like to support the channel. But for now, let's get my thoughts on the journey so far, live from the sitting lounge. So I just had to find somewhere quiet. I'm actually in the sitting lounge now, the appropriately named sitting lounge, because they're playing constant music in the business lounge, and of course that's nice enough, but for YouTube it's a no-no because you'll get a copyright strike. So far, what do I like about this ship? It's very clean, it's very modern. I'm not really a seafaring type person, as I've said on previous videos. I normally don't get sea legs. I'm not what you would call a qualified mariner at all. That said, it's a very smooth sailing today. So what I can tell you about this ship is that it seems to be split largely over three or four passenger decks. The main deck has the shop, which goes from pretty much from front to back. It also has the two lounges, the comfort lounge and the business lounge, which you've seen already. Then at the top of the ship, there are, believe it or not, some cabins. Nobody needs a cabin for a tour of sailing, clearly. Well, you might. I can't think of a reason why you would need a cabin for a tour of ship sailing. But it does have them, and that's for the simple reason that this ship, along with the sister ships in the fleet, sometimes do overnight sailings. It is very nice. It's a very, very nice ship compared to some of the others that I travel on. Not too often, thankfully. Like I say, I'm really not the seafaring, seagoing type. I far prefer flying, or driving, or even getting the bus. But it's nice enough. It's a very nice ship. And the reason why I'm talking so quietly is because the first thing that you notice as soon as you get on board this ship, and right throughout the entire crossing, is that it's just quiet. I mean, we are going probably full speed, whatever that means in ship terms, in nautical terms, maximum knots, I don't know. Anchors away. You see, I'm clueless of stuff like this. But no, I think it's anchors away when the ship leaves, isn't it? Yeah, because if we still had the anchor down, the ship wouldn't be going anywhere. So, yeah, ignore that bit. So, we are going fast, right? I think, as fast as the captain and these things go. And it is so smooth. So, I priced up my favourite, as you saw in the video, I priced up my favourite Bushmills, €22 for a similar size bottle, the 750ml, as you'd get in Sainsbury's on special offer for sometimes £20, so broadly similar pricing. But I don't check a bag in on the flight, so I'll not buy one today, I don't think, because then I'd have to check the bag in and all that blah on the way back if I didn't drink it back then. I don't drink a bottle of whiskey a day. In the distance on the horizon, we see fellow Tallink ship Silja Europa. Silja Europa is known as one of the first ships to have responded to the distress calls of MS Estonia here in the Baltic Sea in late September 1994. It was just west of here when, that fateful 28th of September night, in the dark, icy Baltic waters, the Estonia sank with the loss of 852 lives, making it one of the world's worst ever maritime disasters. 28 years on, and the cause of the disaster is still disputed by some. Whilst the official report blamed rough seas causing the visor to break on what was an insufficiently designed structure and flooding the ship, various conspiracies include a submarine strike and deliberate sabotage. Today, Estonia remains where she laid, just 85 metres below the waterline. But back to today's video, and I'm now on the cabin deck.
So I'm on the cabin deck. I wanted to try and find an open cabin just to show you, but everything's locked up. So, as I suspected, demand for cabins on a tour of daytime sailing is probably quite limited. But there you go. There you go.
As we approach Tallinn, the weather has really started to close in, as you can see. And guess who didn't bring a jacket on this trip? To one of the coldest regions on Earth. Fortunately, the sleet did stop enough for me to walk to my hotel as I arrived into Tallinn, itself a stunning city to visit. All that remains to say is that I really enjoyed today's trip on the Tallink Megastar. It really does have something for everyone, and I can highly recommend it when sailing across the Baltic. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.